is what, according to you, can be done by the government now to ensure that justice is indeed meted out, not just in word but also in spirit, not just in letter but also in spirit, so that the people in Bhopal who've suffered for 26 years don't continue to suffer so endlessly?
Hasn't been sleeping, and the government is today not unconcerned, but let the government, the relevant people in the government, to take at least look, take a look at the judgment, let us take a look at the totality and come out with an answer. You can't hold a gun to someone's head and say, you reply on behalf of the whole government. I'm sure the government will have a formal reply. We will talk about it. The law minister has given his immediate response. It's a strong response. We should respect it and then now wait for what more he intends to do. He will tell the country.
Okay, we're also reading about the Public Liabilities Insurance Act, which apparently even now says that there is a cap of 5 crore rupees, irrespective of the extent of damage to life and environment. Do you also believe, Mr. Khurshid, as the Corporate Affairs Minister, there's a need to rework some of those laws?
If I did, I wasn't going to tell you, because we have to take a decision in the government before we come to a conclusion. But please understand, again, this is propaganda. The cap is only about being able to seek, is a certain cap, because you are able then to seek from a centralized fund. Further liability can be taken care of through a centralized fund. It's a total system by which there is apportionment of liability. Now please let the law first come to Parliament, and then can be discussed. If there is inadequacy, it will be addressed.
Okay, you're holding out the promise that the government will do what it can to ensure that justice is meted out for the moment. Salman Khurshid, thank you very much for joining us on the show this evening. I want to go across now to Aslam Sher Khan, former Olympic player and also Congress leader, joining us from Bhopal. Mr. Khan, you've lived in Bhopal, you've seen what happened very closely. When the central government comes out and says that we've done what we can and there's nothing wrong in the way the system functioned, is that a brief you agree with? Is that a response you agree with, Mr. Khan?
Rahul, you know that after this year media come and you people come in, and now the basically the people getting little bit justice. Otherwise, this Holocaust or whatever you say, this is a tragedy or disaster of the any kind of, like what happened in Hiroshima and what in Nagasaki. The people in Bhopal, those people living around the Union Carbide factory, they were killed instantly. And people of Bhopal was running around, people know where they're going to running, and that night and early morning, people was almost, the entire town was dead. I was not in Bhopal because I was contesting election 1984 in from Betul, so I heard stories, and ultimately because I'm born and brought up in Bhopal, I know what the Bhopal people feel. You don't expect anything from the government. You don't expect anything from the CBI and whatever, these people are not going to do anything. When they not done that time was the tragedy which people can do. Heartfelt approach to do the justice for the people of Bhopal. But as you see the Warren, you're talking about the Warren Anderson, the chairman come Bhopal, and the people of that time of the government people were sending back to the America, and America was involved again. And you know what happened after that. So the Bhopal people getting justice, when you people will make this point, that the media make this point, that is what happened. And then this, the future Holocaust or anything of disaster of this magnitude will be, because you see what happened, which side was the Union Carbide? The Union Carbide in the old city, and the old city was around was the poor people, the people from downtrodden, the people are Dalit, the Muslims. And those guys were skilled like anything. And these people, who cared for them? And what is stake they are in the politics? They have no stake in politics. They have no stake in the government. That's why their case going like this. And you see that what happened to the judgment in Bhopal. 2 years jail, and that also they are getting everything. So this is the country. Now the time is come, the people of this country have to be stood up and see that every citizen of this country is equal to anyone. And you see that when the people died, and the rich people died, if it was the rich people of Bhopal or the government of Madhya Pradesh, secretaries and all people died on that night, you can see the different story in this country. So this is the time, and this is the, and you see the what happening in the Bhopal road. The poor people, they are asking for justice, and they're never going to get justice. What happened to the Ruchika case? If you guys not come in the picture, Madhav, she was killed. So you see, this is the country that is going on. You don't go about, you people have to take this case. What happening? What happened? And then I think that those people, the poor people, unknown people died in this tragedy, they get some solace of this.
Well, what a sad state of affairs this really is. We've got a former Olympian coming on the show, a politician from Bhopal, saying till the time the media takes this up, no justice will be done. It just shows how other systems and institutions in this country are crumbling. And when the media takes up an issue like the Ruchika Gehrotra murder case, then they're saying there's a media trial that's going on. Because the fashion in which this trial has gone on has been witnessed by people across the country for 25 years. And at the end of it, the seven accused, not even including the main accused who's gotten away completely scot-free, the seven accused have gotten away with a 1 rupee fine per person who was killed that night and just 58 minutes in prison. If this calls for a media trial, if a media trial can change things in Bhopal for all the lakhs who've suffered since, then so be it. For the moment, to all our guests, KTS Tulsi, Nirmala Sitaraman, Raghu Rai, Aslam Sher Khan, Rachna Dhingra, and Atulanjan, thank you very much for joining us on the Center Stage Face-Off tonight.